Kubernetes has been on our technology radar for a couple of years, but we're seeing two interesting movements around Kubernetes. We're seeing a shift in our client demand moving from PaaS as an application runtime to container runtime as a platform, while converging on Kubernetes as the container orchestrator of choice. We're seeing a rapid growth in both commercial and open source technologies enriching the ecosystem around Kubernetes.
We're beginning to see Kubernetes dominate the market, not just because of the power of Google's developer evangelism, but mainly because as the industry is standardizing on containers as the main contract between developers and platform or operations teams, Kubernetes has struck a nice balance in the granularity of the control and abstraction it provides for automating deployment, scaling, and operation of multiple containers. We're excited about the innovation happening in the active ecosystem around Kubernetes. The concept of pods has been a key enabler for the emergence of things like sidecars and service mesh technologies, which we're beginning to experiment with. We're still a little wary, and think you should be, and we always warn against web scale envy. Sometimes simpler managed container runtimes are all you actually need, particularly given the non-trivial nature of standing up and operating a whole cluster. In this radar, we call out Kops as a great command line tool for creating and managing high availability production clusters, and also Sonobuoy, which is a diagnostic tool for checking conformance and doing diagnostics and monitoring of your clusters. But given the complexity of running your own cluster, we're also seeing the growth in managed Kubernetes offerings. Many of the major PaaSes are exposing raw Kubernetes offerings, but we are particularly calling out Google's Kubernetes-backed container engine, GKE, which offloads a lot of the operational concerns of managing a cluster and provides good APIs and standards for interacting with it. In the future, we're expecting to see further growth in the vendor landscape, such as Pivotal's PKS, and also open source initiatives like the Open Service Broker API, which should create a rich and open ecosystem of services around Kubernetes.